Hey guys, thanks for watching. Here you are, the last part of the video on how to make computer run faster. Keep watching. MCCS, transforming experience, presenting opportunities. Tip number 28. Always keep the paging file or virtual memory or swap file turned on. You might have heard that turning off the paging file speeds up computer's performance, which is not true. Let's learn why we should keep it turned on. What is paging file? A paging file is an optional hidden system file on a hard disk that lets the system use physical memory more efficiently. The paging file allows the computer to perform smoothly by reducing the workload of the physical memory called RAM. Should you turn off paging file? No. Turning off the paging file on C or boot drive will cause problems when running a software that requires a large amount of memory. The apps will crash instead of being swapped out of the RAM into the page file. Does increasing the size of paging file increase system performance? The answer is no. Should you turn off the paging file if you have a lot of RAM? The answer is no matter how much RAM you have, paging file should be enabled all the time, especially on C or boot drive. Let's learn how to turn it off. Right click on this PC and choose properties. Once you are here, click on advanced system settings. On advanced tab, under performance, click on settings. In this window, click on advanced tab. If you see here, there is written virtual memory. A paging file is an area on the hard disk that Windows uses as if it were RAM. Click on change and tick the automatically manage paging file size. Here you can choose any drive if you want to turn off the paging file. This is C drive. For my D drive, it is no paging file. For F drive, it is no paging file, it is on C drive, so it is turned on. So if you want to turn off the paging file on C drive, you can put a check mark on no paging file and click on OK. In my computer, I don't want to turn it off. I click on cancel. That's it. Tip number 29. Always use Windows security and remove any third-party antivirus software. It's free and it includes easy to use features such as antivirus, firewall, network security, smart screen filter. It also includes the ability to block ransomware and other types of malicious activities. Tip number 30. Perform a Windows Defender offline scan. You know Windows has 4 scan options, and each of them does exceptional scan of your computer, such as quick scan, full scan, custom scan, and offline scan. How to do an offline scan? You go to start search and type Windows security. On the top result, Windows security, click on this. On the left pane, click on virus and threat protection. In this window, you have the options quick scan and click for scan options. Scroll down. After quick scan, you can do a full scan, custom scan, and a Microsoft Defender offline scan. If you put a check mark on Microsoft Defender offline scan and click on scan now, so some malicious software can be particularly difficult to remove from your device. Microsoft Defender offline can help find and remove them using up-to-date threat definitions. This will restart your device and will take about 15 minutes. So it is strongly recommended to do a Microsoft Defender offline scan on your computer. That's it. Tip number 31. Start a maintenance task on your computer. If you feel your computer is acting up, do a maintenance if you haven't scheduled it yet. How we do it? Go to search, type CP, control panel, click on system and security, click on security and maintenance. expand the maintenance, you see here, there is written start maintenance. You can click on start maintenance and do a maintenance for your computer. If you click on change maintenance setting, by default, run maintenance tasks daily at 2 a.m. You can also schedule it, like I schedule it at 12 p.m. at my lunch time. I put a check mark on allow schedule maintenance and click on OK. That's it. Tip number 32. Check computer's memory and upgrade your RAM if needed. How to know if you need more memory for your computer? There are two ways to know if you need more memory for your computer. One is Windows Task Manager, the other one is Windows Memory Diagnostic. Let's check it. Go to Task Manager, right click on Show Hidden Icon and choose Task Manager. On Task Manager window, on Performance tab, click on Memory. If this percentage is around 80, it means you need more memory. You can also check how much memory you have, like I have 12 GB memory, and the type is DDR3. If you look at the bottom of this window, you will find more information about the RAM you use for your computer. For example, you will see how many slots your computer has, like mine is 2 of 4. You can also check the form factor of the memory. So this is the one method. The second method is, you go to search and write Windows Memory Diagnostic. Click on Windows Memory Diagnostic. There will be a small window pop up. Resort now and check for problems recommended. Save your work and close any programs before restarting. So if you do not have any programs opened, you can click on the first option. Otherwise, you can click on the second option. For the next time when you restart your computer, you will see the information about the RAM of your computer. As an example, let's try the first option. When your computer is restarted, you will see this window. Windows Memory Diagnostic tool is running and checking for the any error. That's it, guys. Tip number 33. Enable ReadyBoost. What is ReadyBoost? ReadyBoost is a very useful feature that uses a removable drive, such as a flash drive or SD card, to cache files and boosts the overall performance without the need of adding more memory. Points to consider. If you are not in the position or you don't have time to buy more RAM, it is best to enable ReadyBoost. Enable ReadyBoost if you use HDD. No need to enable ReadyBoost if you use SSD. To enable ReadyBoost on Windows, I connect a USB flash drive of 32 GB. How I do it? Open this PC and you will see the flash drive here. Right click on flash drive and select properties. On the properties window, click on ReadyBoost. Here, put a check mark on dedicate this device to ReadyBoost. Here you write the amount. For example, I write 20,000 MB. Click on apply. Click on OK. Now the ReadyBoost is enabled, which results a very good performance for your computer. If you want to disable the ReadyBoost, you right click on flash drive, go to properties, select ReadyBoost, and put a check mark on do not use this device. Click on apply and click on OK. That's it, guys. Tip number 34. Reset your computer. Guys, if nothing seems to increase performance, you can reset your computer to an initiate or factory state with a clean copy of Windows to improve the startup, shutdown, battery life, and overall performance. How can we do it? Go to search, type reset this PC, click on reset this PC result. Once you are here, you simply click on get started. In this window, it gives you two options: keep my files, remove apps and settings, but keeps your personal files. Remove everything. Removes all of your personal files, apps and settings. We recommend you to do the second option, remove everything. But before you do this, you have to have a backup of all your files in an external drive, and then do the rest of the procedures based on resetting your computer. That's it, guys. Tip number 35, Windows reinstallation. Do it for the extreme option and consistent issues or errors if reset and all other tips don't work for you. Tip number 36, change HDD to SSD. If after spending the time tweaking and reducing settings, resetting and reinstalling Windows, but you are still not seeing any improvements in performance, perhaps it is time to change your HDD to SSD. Changing HDD to SSD is one of the best things you can do to increase performance of your computer. Tip number 37, buy a new computer. If you think nothing works at all, just consider a new computer. Hey guys, it was the last part of the tutorial on how to make computer run faster. We need your support by liking our videos and subscribing to our YouTube channel. And also hit the bell button as all to get notified for our more next videos. It will be very nice of you if you write any comment for the encouragement, ideas, suggestions and questions. You can also go to our channel and tap on video section for more videos. Thanks for all your support. Good luck. Have a nice day.